Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm gonna show you how to fix the 410 gone error. If you incorrectly type a URL, you may see a 404 error explaining that this web page doesn't exist. However, if the page has been deleted, you'll likely receive a 410 gone status code. This means you won't be able to access the page at all. Fortunately, there are a few ways to fix the 410 gone error. But before we dive into how to understand and fix this error, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember to subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, what's the difference between 410 gone and 404 not found? Both the 410 gone and 404 not found errors indicate that the resource cannot be retrieved. However, there are a few main differences between the two HTTP status codes. 404 not found is one of the most common HTTP status codes. When you see this error, it means that the requested resource does not exist. However, a 404 not found error is a temporary problem. This means that you can try the URL again later to see if the problem has been resolved. With the 410 gone error, the requested page has been permanently deleted. When search crawlers identify this HTTP status code, they will de-index the link. This can also inform other website owners to remove the link from their content. If you don't need a particular page anymore, it can be useful to implement a 410 gone redirect. However, if these errors happen on their own, you'll need to fix them to keep your website performing properly. There are many ways you can fix the 410 gone error. By troubleshooting both the client and server sides, you can ensure that your content can be viewed by visitors and indexed by search engines. Since many of these methods involve altering site files, updates, and plugins, we recommend backing up your website first. Before you start making changes to your server, you can troubleshoot your website on the client side. This can be a simple way to fix the error without altering vital site files. When you first experience the 410 gone error, it's a good idea to check the link. As we discussed earlier, inputting an incorrect URL can cause this HTTP status code. If you're trying to reach a web page that has been permanently deleted, it will likely respond with a 410 gone error. This happens because the server disallowed access to that URL. First, you can try retyping the address. If you still see the 410 gone status code, you can search for that page by typing in a few keywords in the search engine. The website owner might have moved that page to a new URL. By searching for some keywords and entering the website's name, you could find what you're looking for on a new page. Once you notice that your web page has been replaced with a 410 gone error, you can consider downgrading your WordPress software to an older version. Sometimes implementing new tools can lead to poor configuration or unexpected problems like the 410 error. If you backed up your website before the update, you can easily restore this previous version. With our Kinsta hosting plans, you'll receive automatic daily backups for all of your websites, even your staging sites. To restore your backup, open your My Kinsta dashboard, then go to Sites and select your website. On the new page, click on the Backups tab. Here, you'll see a history of your backups. Find the backup that you want to restore. Next, locate the Restore To button and select whether you want to downgrade your live site or its staging environment. Finally, you'll need to confirm the backup restoration. Once the restoration process is complete, you'll be able to access your WordPress dashboard again. If the 410 gone issue persists, you'll need to try another method. If you have installed plugins or extensions that alter your URL structure or redirects, these can cause the 410 error as well. You may see this HTTP status code in other cases because of general incompatibility issues. Either way, you can solve the problem by uninstalling these tools. To see if your plugins are causing the issue, you can deactivate them all. Since 410 errors don't usually lock you out of the WordPress dashboard, you can do this on your plugins page. Start by selecting all of your plugins. Then, from the Bulk Actions drop-down menu, click on Deactivate. Finally, click on Apply. This should deactivate all of the plugins on your website simultaneously. Now, you can check to see if the 410 gone error has been resolved. If so, you can reactivate each plugin one by one to find and delete the culprit. If it serves a vital purpose on your website, you can find a similar plugin or contact its developer about the issue. Since the 410 gone error can result from a server-side issue, you may not see any improvements on the client side of your website. After you've tried the first method with no results, you may need to make changes to your server configuration. You can check your server logs if you want to know whether your server is experiencing any 410 gone errors. This will help you monitor all of your HTTP status codes and identify what's causing the errors. If you have a Kinsta hosting plan, you can review your site logs directly from your dashboard. Once you log into My Kinsta, go to Sites and then Logs. The log viewer will automatically show your error logs, so you'll need to select access.log from the drop-down menu. This will display all of the HTTP requests for your website. Each line will look something like this. In this example, the request gained a 302 HTTP status code. The requested URL was wp-admin. You can scan your HTTP request for 410 errors in your site logs. You can also use the search bar to narrow down your results. If you find any errors, you can identify the specific web page that is down. If the 410 gone error persists, it's time to debug your website. To do this, you can use the Query Monitor plugin. This free tool enables you to view the performance of your database queries, as well as PHP errors, enqueued scripts, HTTP API calls, and more. First, download and install Query Monitor. Then, click on the New tab at the top of your dashboard. To monitor all of your server-side HTTP requests, select HTTP API calls. This will show you all of the server-side queries for your website. Here, you can see if any errors occur while loading your website. You'll likely need to check your server configuration if you notice any 410 gone errors. However, if you need any help, you can contact your hosting provider. Your WordPress website has a htaccess file that contains rules about your server configuration. If you recently made changes to this file, it could create a 410 gone error. To check the configuration of the htaccess file, you'll need to open your site files. Often the easiest way to do this is through a secure file transfer protocol client. This will enable you to connect to your server. If you're using a Kinsta hosting plan, you can start by logging into your My Kinsta dashboard. Then navigate to Sites and select your website. Next, find the SFTP SSH section. This will contain your login information for SFTP access, including the host number, username, password, and port. Now you'll need to open an FTP client like FileZilla. Once you download this software, you'll need to change the settings from FTP to SFTP access. This provides a safer way to connect to your site. To do this, go to File and then Site Manager. Here, create a new site. Then change the protocol to SFTP SSH File Transfer Protocol. Copy your host and port number from My Kinsta. Next, paste these details into the respective boxes and hit Connect. To finish connecting to your server, enter your username and password and click on OK. After you successfully log in, navigate to the public HTML folder. Then find the htaccess file and open it. Here's what your htaccess file might look like. However, you may see some changes to this file. If you notice any rules containing a redirect 410, you can go ahead and delete them. If your htaccess file looks similar to the one listed on our screenshot, you don't have to make any changes. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.